I've always gravitated toward rhythm. I mean, I started out playing percussion and drums, and then I switched to guitar, so maybe that was the reason why. But with ritualism, like you said, you can think of it as 11-8. I tend to think of things, I try to kind of subdivide it. I think of it as 5.5, for example. Very simply, 5.5 would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1. That's one example of 5.5, where the long beat is at the end. At first, it feels very unnatural to do this, but once you practice that diligently, like anything else you practice, changes, you know, things like that, you start to get used to it, you know. You take that and you start to work certain rhythms over it. Very simple at first. Like the easiest thing to play over would be like straight eighth notes. Just take like that. Most people can do that pretty easy. Once they get the foot, because actually this can be a little tricky. A lot of people will go one. Yeah, you don't think 4-4, you know, and you shouldn't have to think 9 or 11 or 13 or any of that stuff. And, you know, all you have to do is look to different cultures to Greek music, for example. And there was a class called Dalcroze Eurythmics that was a requirement that we had to take in school at NYU. And it was basically, it's a method of teaching rhythm through bodily movements. And, you basically have to get up and stomp around the room and, you know, stomp certain rhythms and clap other rhythms counter to it, you know. But it was a very helpful way to teach rhythm through bodily movements, which conceptually is really where it comes from, you know. And, you know, everybody cursed having to take this class because they felt like, you know, they were in kindergarten or something. I loved the class. I mean, I thought it was, like, I learned more in that class than most of my other classes, you know. Steve Coleman, a lot of people in the M-Bass Collective, it was Greg Osby and Robin Eubanks, Cassandra Wilson, Marvin Smitty Smith, a band called Lost Tribe with Adam Rogers and Ben Porowski and Dave Binney and Fema Ephron, Don Byron, Wayne Shorter, of course. I played in his band a few years and recorded with him. Randy Brecker, Sam Rivers, Dave Holland, Robbie Coltrane, who I'm on tour with now, of course. Lenny White, the list goes on.